If you want to become this, then you need to stop doing what this guy is doing and start doing what this guy is doing. But how do you know what this guy is doing if he never tells you what he's doing and keeps all his secrets to himself? Two words. Forceful interrogation. I'm kidding. That was a joke. It was a joke. Please don't arrest me. Instead, I'm just gonna tell you, honestly, that's it. And it's not like grand champs like to keep their techniques secret, but a lot of them just use these techniques instinctively and don't really notice them or are even able to point them out. And that's what this video is about, teaching you the small, advanced techniques that almost all grand champs use but don't really tell you, because they don't notice they're actually using them. But first, 74% of you apparently don't want to reach grand champ, so to fix that, all you have to do is hit that sexy red button that says subscribe and turn on notifications for this channel. Alright, let's get to these grand champ secrets. Number 1. The race is on. You and your opponents have locked eyes on the same boost. But who's gonna get there first? You use all your boost to be faster than him and beat him to the boost, and it worked. You beat him by just a few inches and secured the boost. So let me save you another broken controller by telling you the simplest way to fix this issue. You just jump. Literally all you have to do is jump, and you'll win the boost like 80% of the time. This works on your opponents, and it even works on your teammates. I can't lie, there's been a couple times where my teammates were just not really pulling their weight, and I was desperately trying to win that game alone. But sure enough, here comes Mr. Bot teammate trying to steal my boost so he can sit in net and watch me carry him. But whatever, it's fine, I'll just hit him with a little jump and take that boost for myself. But remember, don't be an ass. If you're the guy at the bottom of the scoreboard and you're using this to steal their boost, then I'm sorry to say, but you're an asshole. But you should definitely abuse this technique to steal boosts from your opponents, because then that's just smart gameplay. And honestly, I have no idea why this works, but it does. So just use it and you'll get more boost. And there's not really a special way to do this. All you have to do is just jump before you hit the boost, and that's it. Really simple. Number 2. Your car has body parts. This is the head, this is the nose, these top corners are the arms, and these back corners are the legs. Now, since this is soccer, you might think, oh, I have to use my car's legs to hit the ball, right? Yeah, that doesn't really work. Instead, you should think of it like volleyball. If you want a really powerful and accurate shot, you don't use your nose, you don't use your head, you use your arms. This also applies to Rocket League. Whenever you want a powerful and accurate shot, using your arms is the easiest way to do that. Yes, you can also do it with other parts of your car, but using the car's arms, or the two top corners, is the most consistent and easy way to do this. And in order to be a grand champ, you need to be very consistent in everything you do. Using the top corners of your car for power shots and air shots makes consistency way easier. Plus, if you use this with the last technique, you can pretty much score whenever you want. Stick around to the end and I'll show you what I mean. Number 3. Don't you just love 50-50s? It's great, because you always win them, right? Well, this third technique can help you a lot with certain types of 50-50s. And this is a technique I use pretty often, and it's most effective when the ball is rolling on the ground. If it's an air 50-50, it's not as effective. But the most common scenario to use this is when the ball is close to the opponent's net and the goalie is right behind the ball. This is a great way to kind of brute force your way through the defender and score a goal. Imagine it like this play from Marshawn Lynch.
Kill him!
First and goal back at the 15. Lynch not gonna get anything. Well, maybe second effort. What comes out the back of it? And he's in! Touchdown!
When you wanna just force a 50-50 to go forward, this technique is effective. So whenever you're head-on with your opponent and the ball is rolling on the ground, as the 50-50 is about to happen, use a front flip cancel and hold that position through the 50-50. This creates an angle with your car that forces the ball to go forward regardless of what the opponent does. Even if it doesn't go straight forward, you usually win the 50-50 by using this. So it's rarely a bad move. It would only be bad if you try this for an air 50-50 or if you're coming from the side. This is mainly for head-on rolling 50-50s. Number 4. Putting your balls to the side. Now, before you start putting your hand down your pants, I'm talking about Rocket League balls. When an opponent is challenging you and it seems you have him beat to the initial touch, instead of just hitting it normally, which will probably lead to a 50-50 or them just hitting it back to you, try to hit the ball around them. And this works for a bunch of different scenarios, but you'd be surprised how easy it is to hit balls around your opponents. All it takes is using the corner of your car and a side flip to hit it around them instead of directly going into them. And this often leads to goals or 1v2 scenarios and helps you get in the mindset of outsmarting your opponents rather than just hitting shots and praying they go in. This switch in your mindset will get you closer to champ and eventually grand champ. You should always be thinking, how can I outsmart my opponents? Remember, work smarter, not harder. Number 5. Momentum placement. This last one is a bit more advanced and requires that you have some sort of control with where you can place your shots. Once you have a bit of control and can make the decision to hit the ball on the left side of the goal or the right side of the goal, using momentum placement can catch a lot of opponents off guard and lead to easy goals. And this sort of gameplay really only starts to happen around Champ 1 and above, but the sooner you know about this, the sooner you can learn it to reach those high ranks. And momentum placement has to do with the momentum of your opponent. You want to place the ball opposite of the momentum that your opponent has. For example, this defender is moving in line with the goal from right to left. The left side of the goal is completely open, but their momentum is taking them to that left side. You want to place the ball opposite of their momentum. So instead of shooting the ball to the left, which is the same direction that they are heading, you want to place the ball on the right side, which is opposite of their momentum. And this applies to other scenarios too. For example, this defender is slowly shadowing my dribble. The opposite of slow is fast, so I can shoot a fast power shot to catch them off guard. So it's a good idea to start thinking, what momentum does my opponent have, and how can I do the opposite? However, you shouldn't only use this technique. This should mainly be used when your normal shots are not working and you need to do something differently to catch them off guard. And each situation you use this in has different levels of effectiveness, but the most important one and the most effective situation to use this in is when the opponent is defending in goal, moving either left or right. All you need to do is place the ball in the opposite direction that they're heading. And if you can't place the ball where you want it yet, make sure to practice training packs to improve your accuracy before using this technique. Because if you can't put the ball on the left or right side of the goal on command, then, well, this technique is kind of useless. So make sure you're at least somewhat accurate with your shots before relying on this technique. And if you pair this with number 3, or using the top corners of your car, it can lead to some seriously effective and easy goals. All right, and that's it. Those are 5 techniques that grand champs like to keep a secret. Not necessarily on purpose, but just because they don't realize they're doing them. Alright, let's recap. Number 1. Whenever two cars are going for a boost pad at the same time, the car that jumps will get the boost more often than the car that doesn't jump. Number 2. Your car has body parts. Use the top corners of your car, aka the arms, for consistently powerful and accurate shots. Number 3. Use a front flip cancel for head-on rolling 50-50s to make the ball go forward almost every time. Number 4. Just put your balls to the side, man. It's really that simple. Number 5. Place the ball opposite of your opponent's momentum. If they're going left, place the ball to the right. If they're going right, place the ball to the left. Simple as that. Alright, there you go. Now you have the tools to reach Grand Champ yourself. Or at least try. And let me know down below in the comment section what you think about these techniques and if you already use any of them. And as always, don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and I'll see you next Saturday.